Welcome, Stella and Kaylee. I am really excited about what we're going to start working on for the next 2 weeks. Our time is coming to a close for this school year, and I'm just so excited to work on how to draw people or how to draw a person's face. So today we are going to be practicing and talking about how to figure out where everything goes. And then I've got, so we'll do the guidelines on one side and then I'll have you draw on the other on your own. And then next week we will be doing a self-portrait with I think chalk pastels, which will just be a lot of fun. What you need today is the sheet of paper where I have one kind of egg-shaped oval on there, and it has your name. That's going to be your practice one. You also are going to want a pencil, possibly a marker so you can, I might use that so you can see this better. And since I have an egg-shaped head, I have my egg-shaped eraser. So you're going to want an eraser with you as well. The other thing that might be helpful and convenient is a ruler. You don't have to have a ruler because nothing's really going to be straight, but it helps kind of divide things up. So you can, when I say we are going to divide that in half, you can use a ruler if that makes you feel better. All right, let's get started. I have drawn for you basically an oval shape that gets a little bit narrower at the bottom. That's going to be where our chin is. We are just going to do the basic shape of a human face. So it's not going to be anyone in particular. It's just so that we can figure out, on average, where all the facial features are on a human face. So the very first thing that we're going to do is we are going to divide our oval in half from top to bottom. So we want to put a line across it. This is when you could use your ruler if you want. I look at this and it's about 8 inches. This would be 4 is half of 8. You could do it that way, or you can kind of eyeball it. Sometimes I like to take I would put a little mark and I'd say, I think this is about halfway. Then I would take my pencil and I would put the top of it to the edge of the oval, and then I would put my finger here on that pencil. Now you don't take that off and you switch it and you see if they're equal. Okay, so this is a little bit longer. So I am, let me just check that one more time. So the pencil's a little bit longer, which means I just need to make the bottom part a little bit longer. Or I could also move that. So we're just going to do a basic line that divides the top from the bottom. This doesn't have to be anything perfect. The other thing you could do is you could measure by your hand. You could put a line with the width of your hand, and then that might give you a good start for the middle. So we're going to do the middle by dividing the top and the bottom. Then we want to divide it from side to side. So I'm just going to eyeball it, okay? It just doesn't, again, you can measure it if you want. I'm going to check it with my pencil measurement. So I've got it up against this line that I used to divide. I'm putting my fingers right here on the edge of my oval, and I'm bringing that over, and you can see it's just about equal. So that's good enough because this is just giving us a general idea. Now, we're going to take this bottom half and we want to divide that in half as well. So I'll check it. That's a little bit short, so I'm going to bring it down just a bit. You can always go in, and if you have too many lines, then you can just start erasing some of them if you have lines that aren't going to work. So you should have your top part, and then you should have the second half, and that second half should be divided in half. Now we're going to divide, so we're going to take the bottom half and we're going to divide it in half. And this again, these are all going to tell us where our facial features are going to go. So on this middle line that divides up our oval, that's where our eyes are going to go. And what I want you to do is kind of, we're going to guess, and it's usually about 5 eyeballs that fit across the space. So You can take your pencil and you can just test it. So that's a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's about what you'll end up doing is having two lines that will be the width of the eye that you're going to put in. So if you need to take a little break, if you want to use your ruler, you can do that. But basically what you're doing is you're putting in two lines that are equally apart from this middle one. And then you're going to take that measurement and you're going to measure that two more times so that you have about that same width across. I know this can be complicated, so if you need to move the video back to watch it again, go ahead and do that. So we're going to put our basic shape for our eyes in, which is kind of, it's another oval. It tends to get pointed on the interior of your eye. You're going to be doing a circle. So you can do your oval and you're just going to do it between those two lines that we put there. Now you're going to want them to look kind of the same, so I can see this one was down a little bit more. So I'll make that a little bit smaller. And you can always adjust, okay? You can always adjust. We'll talk about the details for the eyes later. What you can see is that I did two lines over the top. All right, two lines. And that thin line that's created, that would be the eyelids. Then we have our round white area of the eye. And we would go ahead and put pupils in. Like that. Now, the location of these eyes is going to tell us the location of quite a few other things. So we're going to go straight out from this line, and that's going to be the top of our ear. And our ear, in general, is about the length of a nose. But here's something interesting. As you get older, your ears keep growing. Not all your facial features keep growing, but your ears do. So if you're drawing someone that is older, their ears might actually come farther down than their nose. So that's just a little fun fact. Now, it's just like two curved lines for our ears, and you can do a line inside of those. Then we're going to do a dotted line that comes straight down from the corner, the inside corner of our eyes. Now I'm feeling like this space feels a little wide. It is a little bit. So I'll make my eyes a little bigger. Okay. So this is going to be so the whole nose isn't that wide, but just the bottom part tends to come out about that same width of the eyes. So I've got two curved lines here for the nose. You could connect that and I did a fancy little swoop, and that could be your nose, or you could just do a straight line across. Now the bridge of your nose, that's a little bit more narrow. So you can see the reason why I'm gonna put the bridge in is because from that bridge is where we're gonna go up and put our eyebrows in. Now, some people have very different kinds of eyebrows. Some people have really thick eyebrows. Some people have really thin. Some have really kind of bushy, and it's like one eyebrow. It connects and it grows over here. So we're just putting in some average eyebrows. Okay. So we've got our basics here, and that's looking really good. Now we're going to go down to our lips and our mouth. Now there is a little spot, I can't remember what it's officially called, but it's kind of like a diamond shape. So if you make a triangle and then you make another triangle so that it creates a diamond, that helps us shape our lips. So your lips are going to come off of that shape And that tends to be the top part of your lips. Now, some people's lips, everyone has very different lips. So when we're doing our self-portrait, you're going to look at a mirror and you're going to look at your lips. Do you have really thin lips? Or do you have really shaped lips? Do you have a bigger bottom lip than a top lip? Those are the types of questions that you can ask. So I'm just doing a curved line on the bottom, and that comes below the line, and the top lip comes above it. I'm going to separate those two so it's like the mouth is partially open. And that is our basic placement in the facial features. Now, from the ears, that's where we're going to bring our neck down. So every human head, adult head, is about 7 to 8 pounds. So it's very heavy. So you can't, if you start your neck here, it would never hold up your 7 to 8 pound head. So you can have it kind of curve in a little bit with the oval shape, but you do want to make it thick enough. Now we have the neck, and I'm putting a curved line on, and that's like the top of a shirt, a t-shirt maybe, and then we would have our shoulders come off of that. You can see that the way I drew this shape, it was a little bit crooked. If you want to clean up your oval, because I did it too crooked, you can go ahead and you can do that. So what we're missing now is the hair. Now you can say, man, I just don't see how the eyes can be in the middle of the head. That seems weird. There's so much head up here. But the hairline tends to come, it's going to come way down here, and the hair is going to come a little bit in front of the ears. Of course, this depends on what kind of a haircut that the person has that you're drawing. But from here, you can do all sorts of things. And a lot of times, people have thick enough hair that it comes up above their hair. It's not just really tight against it. So I could put in hair that is off to the side, and I can put some lines in to pull across, kind of some bangs like that, right? And it could be short hair, but maybe you have really long hair, and so we have it tucked behind the ear, and then it comes all here as well. It's going to come around. And we're going to add that. Maybe you have a barrette or a clip-in. And so you could fill that in like that. And so now it's starting to, the eyes don't feel like they're in the wrong spot. They really look like they're in the right spot. And I'm just going to bring that hair in just a little bit. So I'm going to let you see where we're at. Okay, those are the basic measurements. So I'm going to put with my marker, I'm going to mark this line. This is half. This is the line that divides the oval in half. This is half, right? This line divides it in half in this way. So then we're going to this part right here is 1/4, okay? And then so is this. It's 1/4 of the whole because we could divide the top in half and then there would be 1, 2, 3, 4. I bet you haven't learned your fractions yet. So I'm sorry if that is confusing. You can write it whatever way that you want to try and remember this. You should have 5 eyes across. That doesn't mean you should have more than 2 eyes, but they should be spaced out the length of 5 eyes. All right? the nose at the bottom. And you can put these little notes on there, is the length of an eye. Okay, so that's how we draw little lines from the corners, these little lines, and that tells us what to do. Can I just mark up some of these? The mouth. Is on the half line here, is between this half, this very bottom half, and it comes, depending on the person, how wide you make it. Okay. Eyebrows. Above eyes, hairline, halfway down from our head and our eyes. Okay, ears, and I'll do that on this side, length of nose. So that fits in this first half. So you know how big to make the ears because you're making it the same length as the nose. Like that. Okay, so now it's all marked up and you're like, I can't hardly see anything. Well, I'm less worried because this was just really our first practice. And what I want you to do is to do it all on your own on this side. And by marking this, now that we've done it together, you will know, and you can look at this for your guidelines. You can see as I outline these, how those facial features stand out a little bit. Oh, and we got a mark. Neck starts bottom of nose, of ear. Okay, so that's where our neck is going to go. And don't forget, depending on what kind of hair you put on here, to start it down low enough on the head. And I'll outline the shirt because that's fun. There we go. All right, Kaylee and Stella, I hope that was not too hard. And what I want you to do on this other side is create another face. On the second one, you could try different hair, but I want all of the facial features in that right spot. So I'm going to draw another face on this side, but I will not talk through it, and I will speed it up so you, if you don't want to watch it and you feel pretty good and you think you can do it, that you can just go ahead and do that, okay? forgot to do on our first one was to add some eyelashes onto your eyelids. I'm going to do that on my guy over here. Now, some people have really short eyelashes and some people have long ones, but everyone has them. They're very important because they help protect our eyes. I'll put these in with a black marker. So you can see that we have the facial features in. I did a kid with short hair, so you could see what that was like. When you are doing your practice one, you can make a girl or a boy. I would encourage you to practice quite a few. If you do one, and then you can flip it over and you could try it again. Try some different hairstyles. I mean, there are so many possibilities. You could make wavy hair or curly hair. You could put glasses on your girl or guy. You could put earrings in, right? You could put a necklace on them. You could, I mean, there are so many fun things that you could do. I want you to have fun experimenting and practicing so that when we work on a final project next week, you'll feel really good about drawing faces because you will have had time to practice. So post your pictures, both of the guidelines of how to do it and your practice one, up on Seesaw so I can check it out. I look forward to seeing what you create.